I mentioned in the previous video that one way you could find negative keywords would be to bid on very broad terms using pay-per-click and then wait for your ads to get impressions and clicks and then to pull up a keyword report and see where your ad was shown, take those terms you wouldn't have liked it to have shown, and then add those as a negative keyword. But I mentioned that'd be really expensive. Now, the good thing is for you, there's a lot of advertisers that are already making this mistake right now. So here's a technique you can use Keyword Grouper Pro and your competitors' ads in order to determine your own negative keywords. So there are a lot of sites out there that offer competitor pay-per-click research. One of them is ISpionage. So you can just put in a domain and you'll hit search and it'll show you they have roughly 52,000 keywords where this advertiser is bidding on terms. Now, all of these sites work the same way. They have a large database of their own keywords. ISpionage boasts that it has 22 million keywords in the database. Then they go out and they crawl those keywords using a Google search. They then take the ads that show and they put it into their database. So then you can then go and put in a competitor's URL and you can find out which keywords your competitors are bidding on. And all of them almost also have the ability to export these terms. So ISpionage is one of them. There's Ahrefs here. You can put in your domain, hit explore. You'll see this is the paid keyword section and you can see the keywords that this advertiser is bidding on. There's Spyfu, same thing, put in the domain, click on PPC keywords under PPC research, and you see here you can export. SEMrush is the same, again, domain, search, you're under positions and paid search positions, and then you'll see the keyword here is in this column. And another old one or older one is KeywordSpy. Again, put in the domain, hit search, and under the PPC keywords tab, you get all the keywords. Now, you can export these, and pretty much all of these, they allow you to export. They're gonna all have a little bit different keyword databases they start with, which means that's why the results would vary. So we'll just take KeywordSpy's database here. They say they have 15,000, 10 keywords from this domain, bidding on flower terms. I've already gone ahead and exported this just to save time. So I've pulled up this export from KeywordSpy, and I'm just simply going to highlight the keyword column here, and I'll scroll to the bottom, to the very bottom, and I will hit Shift, and I'll copy this to the clipboard. Then I'll go back here, and I'll open up Keyword Grouper Pro, and I'll just paste these terms into Keyword Grouper Pro using Control-V. You can right-click and copy, right-click and paste, or you can Control-A and Control-V. And I'll just paste that directly into Keyword Grouper Pro. And once they've been pasted into Keyword Grouper Pro, I just need to set up my minimum group length. Now, for this case, because we're looking specifically for negative keywords, I'm gonna set the minimum group length at 1. And that is explained in another video. There are some videos in the description, some links. You can click on those videos to see how to use Keyword Grouper Pro if you're not familiar with this. Then we need to go to the excluded words list. I'm just gonna go ahead and put in the excluded words for flower and flowers because those are words I know I don't want to group by. So we will put in flower and flowers. And I could also put in arrangement because I know there will be keywords that have arrangements and delivery, okay? So I would put those terms in there. If you think of any really common terms that you know are not negative keywords, you could put those in the excluded words list to use it for this feature. Now, instead of letting this run to save time, I'm just gonna go ahead and show you the results that I got earlier. So I'm gonna click on this tab here, and you'll see that there's about 7,298 groups were created from that list. And if I scroll down through here, you'll see there, these are obviously good terms: florist, gift baskets, shops, send, and you can see the individual keywords here. Now, let me show you a really simple one that would be, as we scroll down through here, we're not gonna go down through all these groups, but I'll show you one. So balloons. So maybe your shop doesn't sell balloons, but you get searches like flowers and balloons, roses and balloons. So immediately you might see this other competitor, they're bidding on balloon terms, but you don't want, you wanna make sure your searches do not show up anything that contains the word balloon. So you'll see here, there's balloons there. We can scroll down through here, balloon bouquet, balloon day, there's balloons plural. There's also, look at this one here. Cooking. So someone put in cooking flour, and I'm pretty sure they meant flour, F-L-O-U-R, but they used flour, F-L-O-W-E-R. So again, you might want to make sure my ads never show if the word cooking is in the query, just to make sure you get rid of those. Maybe you don't offer gift baskets, so you could put in gift basket as a negative keyword. So again, you're just taking the keywords from pay-per-click ads that your competitors are bidding on, and you're sorting those into individual groups, and then just looking down through those groups and taking those terms that you know disqualify this person from seeing your ad. In other words, you don't want your ad to show to someone who typed this in, because it means they're not really a good prospect for your products or services. This is a very simple way to use other people's money where they bid on pay-per-click terms. You can take that data, you can group it, you can make sure your ads are only being shown to people that are actually your target market.